For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
The third edition of the education tsunami struck Brazil on August 13 in 211 municipalities in 26 states as well as the federal district. Thousands of students, teachers, trade unionists, workers, as well as activists from popular movements were out on the streets to protest the far-right Jair Bolsonaro government's regressive pension reforms and in defense of public education. The protests are part of a series of mobilizations in defense of education called by the National Union of Students. They had earlier held demonstrations on May 15th and 30th. Despite the huge mobilizations, the government has not retracted from the planned cuts in education and the implementation of neoliberal pension reforms. The August 13th protests were also against the Future Save project, which aims to attract an international investment of $102 billion in higher education. The project would lead to full-fledged privatization of education in Brazil. In early May, the government announced a 30% budget cut for Brazilian universities and froze graduate grants. The move would reduce spending on services such as electricity, internet, water supply, and other infrastructure. The administration is also planning to stop 3,400 scholarships for scientific research and graduate students. It intends to make a $1,500 million cut to funds for education and a $500 million cut in science and technology projects. The cuts in public education have the objective of amplifying the profit margin of big international conglomerates and transforming education into a commodity for sale.
E a gente está presente aqui hoje contra os cortes na educação, por as escolas já serem sucateadas diariamente. Então a gente se faz presente para mostrar que a escola é nossa e que a gente se preocupa com o nosso futuro. Porque os cortes do projeto Futuros afetam principalmente a nossa esperança e a esperança da juventude.
The mobilizations also denounced the neoliberal pension reform bill, which seeks to raise the minimum retirement age and workers' contributions to the pension fund. As per the current system, men who have contributed to the pension system for 35 years can retire at any age, as can women who have contributed to the system for 30 years. Thus, the average retirement age for both men and women is around 55. However, according to the new system, the minimum age of retirement would be 65 years for men and 62 years for women. The bill also includes provisions that eliminate labor protections for pregnant women and breastfeeding mothers. The protesters held banners in support of former President Lula da Silva and the Lula Libre campaign. The National Union of Students has announced that it will seek support from society, parliament, and academia to present a bill to the National Congress. The bill will guarantee investments in education beyond the spending ceiling and prohibit the contingency of funds from public universities and federal institutes. Brazil also witnessed a huge protest by indigenous women in defense of the differentiated healthcare subsystem of indigenous people. Approximately 1,500 women from 113 indigenous tribes of Brazil occupied the headquarters of the Special Secretariat of Indigenous Health on August 12 in the capital city of Brasilia. They denounced the provisional measure 890, which creates a Doctors for Brazil program, replacing the Cuban-Brazilian initiative More Doctors program.